Hi. Greetings from Ankara, Turkey. I'm Dr. Serdar Güler, a specialist of endocrinology, that's hormonal diseases. We will present you a program that aims to help to understand better health. What's better health? Better health means to live in better conditions. We have to be healthy and we have to be in good mood. And we need some special things to live. Today we will talk about a special subject, that's snoring and upper airway obstructions. And I think this is essential for living, huh?
Of course. We need to breathe for going on living.
What occurs if we don't breathe?
If we don't breathe, our tissues like brain and heart don't get enough oxygen, and it's not possible to survive without less oxygen or without any oxygen.
Oh, then breathing is essential for
breathing,
life.
A healthy breathing is essential.
Not just breathing,
it
also
should
healthy,
be healthy breathing.
Breathing,
yes.
Okay. What do we need to breathe healthy?
We need a open airway, open upper airway to breathe easily and healthily. Mm-hmm. Upper airway starts from nose and goes through the throat, which conducts the air from nose to the lungs. Mm-hmm. So lungs can supply the heart and brain and other tissues with enough oxygen. If you don't have a healthy upper airway, if there is a caliber problem, it has a extra narrowing due to an infection or a mass or some anatomical problems, we can't easily breathe, and that breathing problems causes some metabolic, some systemic diseases.
Also anatomical problems.
Yes.
Thus, you mentioned airway beginning from the nose
yes.
to the throat.
Nose.
Not, you did not include mouth. But some
normally,
people breathe from mouth.
Yes.
Is this a problem?
It's a problem. Normally, the breathing should be done from nose, and the air should conduct from nose to the throat. We have tiny particles, tiny hairs. Uh-huh. In our nose, we have some little tiny tissues, we call it concha, which heats the air and gives a moist to the air. So the air becomes more suitable for the lungs. Breathing through the mouth, it's not appropriate, it's not proper for the lungs. The air becomes less moistured and it becomes more cold. So it causes some infections, some lower airway problems, and it's always hard to fix lower airway problems than the upper airway problems.
The nose also helps in lowering infections
yes.
by keeping the bacteria and virus away
yes.
from the body.
That tiny hairs helps the air getting away from a large particles of some viruses, some bacteria, some polluted air. It helps the air more healthier.
Some people do play with the hairs in the noses.
Yes.
Is this dangerous?
It is very dangerous because that little hair has some follicles, some little cups just between the skin, and they may get infected. Infections of the anterior nose may cause more severe infections through the brain, because the vascular structure vessels are going to the brain through the nose,
yes.
and it may cause very big health problems.
Thus, if you want to clean them, because sometimes the appearance may be ugly, thus we have to use small scissors.
Yes, small scissors, not epilation.
Extra
small scissors.
Small scissors. Thus, we can easily take good care of our nose hairs, which are also essential for
healthy
breathing.
They are essential, yes.
Okay, and sometimes people, people do not snore, not snore.
Yes, they we shouldn't be snoring.
Yeah. Why people do snore? Is this a what is the problem in this?
Snoring, in fact, is a symptom of symptom, and it causes that there is a problem in your airway. Snoring like one night in a week or one night in a month is accepted normal.
Okay.
You may be very tired, you may have an infection that narrows your airway, or your pillow is not so good, your neck is not in a suitable position. Snoring sometimes can be acceptable, but snoring always every night through all night, four nights or more in a week is a problem. It shows even if you are not having an infection, you are snoring, it shows that there is a problem in your upper airway. The air cannot be transferred to the lungs easily. It's an alarm
there's infection. Some kind of obstruction.
There is an obstruction or narrowing. To an infection or a mass or an anatomical problem.
What do we see more frequently in these snoring patients? What's the main problem?
Snoring, as I said before, during a viral infection or bacterial upper airway infections like rhinitis, some influenza or some beta infectious tonsillitis, it's normal. But if there's not an infection, you are snoring, there can be an obstruction in your nose or your throat, or there's a junction between nose and throat behind the nose. We call it nasopharynx. There is a mass or narrowing at that point. Okay. You cannot conduct air easily.
You said first we have to look for infection.
Yes.
If there's infection, snoring may be during the time of infection,
yes,
and it must resolve after
infection.
Infection.
Yes.
But if there's no infection, there is almost always an obstruction or narrowing of the airway, which is very important and generally treatable.
Yes, treatable.
Okay.
Upper airway problems are easy to treat, in fact.
You said there may be a narrowing in nasopharynx or the pharyngeal area, which is about this size and
We can show that if there is a narrowing through the nose or to the nasopharynx area, which conducts the air from nose to throat, or there is a problem in throat region, narrowing problem, they may cause snoring because they narrow the airway passage.
I think most people have adenoids.
Yes.
Or big tonsils.
Yes.
Just at the back of our mouth.
Mm-hmm.
I think they also do cause obstructions and may cause snoring too.
Of course. Adenoid is a lymphoid tissue like tonsil. Mm-hmm. Adenoid is located on posterior to nose on this area. Mm-hmm. And it may, it's always located on all of the children. When we are kids, when we were kids, all of us have adenoid. Mm-hmm. Through the adulthood, adenoid goes away slowly and it diminishes. But some infections or some genetic factors makes this adenoid tissue getting bigger, like this. There is a huge mass in here on nasopharynx, so it causes an airway obstruction. As you also said, tonsils are located on throat, just behind the tongue, and they may narrow also the air passage through the nose to the lower airways. This side, this nasopharynx, adenoid and tonsils are easy to treat.
Are they treated by some pills, medicines, or do they need surgeries?
Yes. Adenoid tissue can be get smaller by some medications. We have several patients that we can use nasal sprays and some medications to get smaller the adenoid tissue. Tonsil tissue is more resistant. Once it gets bigger, it's very hard to get small it with a medication. Tonsil hypertrophy generally needs surgery. When we need adenoid surgery, if it's a very big and there isn't any getting smaller with medications, or it's so big and it causes not also snoring, it causes a total loss of breathing during daytime or during sleep, as we call it apnea, shortness of breath and stopping of the breath for 5 seconds. Or adenoid tissue is just located between 2 ears. And if it causes recurrent ear infections or some fluid accumulation behind the eardrum, which causes some hearing loss, we should remove the adenoid tissue with a surgery.
I see. You have mentioned several problems with this obstruction. When we look at that picture, we see that there's a close interaction between indeed nose and mouth cavities.
Yes.
And does and child is a growing yes. person. All these tissues are very small and get bigger and more functional as yes. we do grow.
Yes.
If there is an obstruction, if there is an adenoid hypertrophy here, does there occur a problem in the development of especially the upper palate
yes.
of the mouth to sometimes causing more problems in breathing, maybe speaking,
yes.
talking, laughing, eating?
Having a huge adenoid cause many problems, in fact. When this area gets smaller with a large adenoid, these facial bones grows to the outwards. And it causes some facial abnormalities. Your face structure becomes more and more bigger. You have very huge maxillary sinuses and maxillary bones. It's a developmental problem because these bones on our cheeks also gives our teeth to the mouth, and these some teeth problems, some getting canine problems, also some chewing problems. Your soft palate also gets more to low, and it gets when it gets low, it's hard to fix it. Yeah. It also causes this soft palate to going down and makes obstruction increased. So also the tongue here, just located on the mouth, it causes tongue to getting out, and we see child's like open mouth during daytime, not only sleeping, and their tongue is just going out, and it causes, as we said before, oral cavity, mouth and tonsil infections more frequently. Having a right and clear breath through the nose is very important, especially during childhood.
Yes. Thus, if there's a problem, if there's snoring or appearances as you have described before, if we see those, we have to visit an ENT specialist
yes.
and be treated regularly and very good
yes.
according to. Otherwise, the development will be very faulty
yes.
and not just spreading, but lots of things will be
yes.
very bad. This is a very important contribution indeed. By doing something very small, you lead to something very good
yes.
over there. This is very promising. Thank you for that. And these are indeed simple problems that
yes.
can be treated effectively
very easily.
And easily and cheaply.
Very
indeed.
Cheaply, of course.
Yeah. Are there other problems that are hard to treat? Important cancers, for example, hard to treat problems?
For this region, the nasopharynx cancer, it's more common in China and Far East. It's really hard to fix with surgery because this area is also is a neighbor of a brain tissue just here, just posteriorly.
Yeah.
So if there is a cancer malignancy in here, it's hard to get a surgery. Generally, we need chemo or radiotherapy very long time. Nasopharyngeal cancer is an adulthood cancer, not a childhood cancer.
Okay.
It's generally seen after 40-year-old age. During childhood, if it isn't an adenoid problem, it could be a lymphoid tissue malignancy, like lymphoma. Today, our medical treatment modalities are very, very easy for lymphoma.
Yeah.
In fact, we only take a biopsy to understand which kind of lymphoma, and then there are several agents of chemotherapy to get rid of this illness.
But I think these are not seen frequently. These
are not
rare,
so frequently.
But also treatable.
Also treatable.
Besides this, I think there are some more common, not mass-related problems,
yes.
but inflammation-related
yes.
problems, such as allergies
yes.
also. Do they also cause significant problems in upper airways?
Of course. We have tiny structures in our nose. We call it concha. Their duty is to filtrate the air and give some moisture to the air. When you have an allergic rhinitis, we have three concha in each side of the nose. When you have allergic rhinitis, these tiny structures getting very bigger, and you have a blocked nose. It's not easy to breathe through the nose.
Getting bigger does not mean better functioning, but
no,
worse
getting
functioning.
Bigger is a worse functioning. There is a liquid like secretion through this concha, and it goes to the posteriorly becoming adenoid more bigger and becomes tonsil more bigger because they are a lymphoid tissue, and they usually give symptoms like there's an adenoid hypertrophy because you can't use your nose, you breathe through the mouth, and you're getting the unfiltered bad air through the mouth without any filtration. But because of you are an allergic person, your lungs are very sensible to the air pollution, and it becomes the allergy more and more worse.
You have started from the concha, then went to adenoids, then tonsils, then to lungs.
Yes,
this allergy is a serious problem.
Yes, allergy is a continuous problem. It is a reaction your body gives to the allergens to the environment, and it's not possible to take out your allergy from your body with a surgery. Allergy means you have to be in control of an ENT or an allergy specialist. You should use some medications on several times of the year, maybe in spring or winter. It's differs from your allergy type. You should be in contact with your doctor, because untreated allergy causes asthma and lower airway allergy. It's easy to fix upper airway allergy, but once it goes to the lungs, the things are not going better.
I see. You said the patient may be symptomatic in some part of the year and
yes.
better in other times.
Yes.
Thus, this is a very important point. If the parents sees that the child has problems, for example, in April,
yes.
they must be careful about what causes this allergy.
Yes.
Is there a specific tree or grass or some animal, something else, or
yes.
something they eat over
of
there?
Of course.
Thus, inform the doctor about that, and he or she will be treated accordingly
yes.
and successfully.
Yes, successfully. Again. Allergy is a very easy illness to treat, but if it isn't goes through the lungs.
Yes, and to prevent lung infections, we have to prevent allergy.
Yes.
And do we have to hurry up? Is it important to treat this in very early ages, or can we wait for years?
It's not usually appropriate to wait for years. In childhood, allergy generally, allergic rhinitis, in fact, the nose allergy, starts like 2 or 3 age. And the child should see an ENT specialist very soon, because allergy, as I said, becomes adenoid more bigger, becomes tonsil more bigger, and we lose the control after a point. During childhood, we want to see the child as soon as possible. But children are very lucky, I think, because half of them or 60% of them, when they get adulthood, they lose their allergy pattern.
Oh, thank God.
They don't go through the adulthood. But in case of adulthood, the allergy starts from the 25 or 30 years of age, and it goes through your life, and it is more easy to get it to go through the lungs and become an asthma. So if your symptoms are complaints are started, you should come.
And prevent lungs to be affected.
Yes. Lower airway is very important for us, and it's always hard to fix them.
To prevent problems in lower way,
yes.
you have to fix problems in the upper airway.
Yes.
That's very good. Then we have some go-home messages over here. Upper airway is very important.
Yes.
Snoring almost always means there's a problem in the upper airway, which is easy to find and cure.
As you know, today all over the world there's a pandemic of coronavirus. And it is shown that in some researches, if you don't use your nose very well, if you have a nose problem or upper airway problem, it is more probable that you will have coronavirus infection through your lungs. And coronavirus infection of lungs are hard to treat. Now we have some medications, but we are losing also our patients because of the lung damage, not because of nose or throat damage. You should have an upper airway healthy, so you can protect your lower airway.
Okay. To summarize, a virus or bacteria or a foreign substance first has to fight with the nose.
Yes.
Then the concha, then the adenoids, then the tonsils.
Yes.
If they overcome all these four obstacles, then they can reach lung.
Yes.
Okay. Then we have to say that you have to have a very healthy nose and throat.
Yes.
To prevent lungs. Is there anything you want to add on this speech? I think we are coming to the end.
Yes. As you said, adenoid and tonsils are very important to fighting for diseases. But when they get very big, they don't functioning like we wanted, and they cause more problems. So I should recommend the patients and the families that don't be afraid of any medication to get smaller adenoid or any surgery for adenoid or tonsil, because we don't operate or we don't get give treatments to the healthy adenoid or healthy tonsil. If we see a problem, we want to fix them, and we want an adenoid tissue with a normal size and normal functioning. We want a tonsil tissue with normal size and normal functioning. When they get bigger, it's not always in their good position. Getting bigger for adenoid and tonsil generally means there is a problem and they cannot work properly. So don't be afraid of surgery or medications for getting smaller.
Body is perfect in every aspect, huh?
Yes.
They have to be everything. They have to be in balance, not big, not small, functioning good. If this is okay, everything is okay. Okay.
Yes.
Thank you very much. Dr. Bahar has very efficiently summarized us upper airway problems. But this is not so simple. Upper airway is very important, as we have learned from Dr. Bahar, to prevent our lungs, which are essential for living.
Yes.
If you don't have lungs, we die.
Of course.
Okay. Africa, have a better night.